In the vast realm of introspection, I observe the world and its people, weaving their stories with the threads of my own curiosity. Each encounter, each reflection, becomes an entry in the tapestry of my understanding. These are my journals. We're often told to find our passion as if it's some magical treasure buried deep within us. But what if everything we've been led to believe is wrong? What if this so-called treasure is merely a mirage, distracting us from something far more profound, yet hidden just beneath the surface of our conscious mind? Before writing this, I stumbled upon a chilling realization. I don't have a passion. And this isn't about a momentary lapse in motivation. It's an unsettling void. By conventional measures, I am successful, but when I search for that fire, that undeniable spark within my soul, I only find an echoing silence. As the shadows of doubt creep in, I begin questioning everything. What is passion, truly? How can we recognize it when we find it? What if what we're really seeking requires us to embrace the unknown, to dare to look into the darkness where the answer might be waiting? This revelation isn't just daunting. It's a relentless whisper that haunts my every thought, driving me to unravel the truth behind what it truly means to live a passionate life. Will I ever discover the secret, or is it already too late? Before we plunge into the murky depths of these thoughts, let's pause to untangle what we mean when we talk about passion. Defined as a strong and barely controllable emotion, passion can be seen as this force that grips a person so tightly that they cannot bear to be separated from it, whether it leads them toward the light or shadow. Yet, in the muted echo of my own revelations, I've come to see my relationship with passion as something unorthodox. Imagine passion as a vast, enigmatic lake where each individual casts their line, eagerly waiting for that perfect catch. This lake symbolizes every conceivable path, the array of passions that life can offer. For most, it's about the catch. For me, it's about the journey. I imagine myself afloat, surrounded by endless possibilities, content with simply having a boat. I savor the light on dancing water, the whispers of the wind, and embrace the unpredictable beauty that surrounds me. I'm not desperately searching for a specific catch, nor am I dictated by its absence. I'm open to whatever the lake may offer, a new fascination, a fleeting interest, or nothing at all. It might seem counterintuitive, even blasphemous in a world fixated on singular obsessions, but in this fluid state, I've found solace. Initially, this perspective felt like a transgression against the norm. Society urges us to discover our singular purpose, our one consuming passion, making those of us who deviate feel like outsiders in a world of resolute pathfinders. However, I've come to see a liberating truth in this detachment from a singular passion, as it grants me the ability to experience many emotions of profound interest, free from the constraints of a predetermined path. It's not that those with defined passions lack the capacity for joy in other areas. Rather, it's that I'm unshackled by focus. I'm allowed to drift between projects, hobbies, ideas, and conversations, welcoming the tides of excitement as they come. Perhaps the true essence of passion is not in finding one perfect thing, but in the freedom to traverse life's vast spectrum and letting myself be moved and touched by each moment. Some may view this as merely a coping mechanism, a way of dancing around the absence of a true passion. Perhaps they're right. Perhaps I'm simply overanalyzing this void. Yet, maybe that's my passion. The endless exploration of thought. As I navigate through this intricate web of thoughts, I can't help but wonder about the myriad of emotions others might experience on this journey. For some, the quest for a singular passion feels like chasing a mirage, a relentless pursuit that leaves them feeling inadequate or lost when they don't find it. For others, there's a comforting certainty in knowing exactly what sets their soul alight. But what if there's another avenue altogether? Imagine the countless decisions people make based on the societal pressure to find that one true passion. Some might feel compelled to commit to a specific career path or lifestyle, fearing that deviating could mean that they've missed their calling. Yet, there's a growing number of us who derive our sense of purpose from a kaleidoscope of passions, each vibrant and unique, like the pieces of a mosaic. Could these diverse passions be the functional equivalent to having one singular passion? I believe they can. The human experience is vast and varied, and our ability to feel passionate about multiple things enriches our lives in unexpected ways. Instead of a solitary beam, our passions become a constellation, each star adding to the brightness of our lives. These multifaceted interests encourage flexibility and resilience. They allow us to pivot when circumstances change, to adapt when life throws us a curveball. By embracing this spectrum of passion, we gain a dynamic sense of fulfillment, one that evolves with us over time. So, whether you find yourself drawn to one overpowering passion or scattered across many, remember that there's no singular path that's true for everyone. Each of us is writing a unique story, filled with the highs and lows of discovery and the ever-present possibility of being enchanted by something new. In embracing the diversity of our interests, we might just realize that passion isn't a destination. Instead, it's an ever-folding journey, a dance with everything that captivates us, leaving its vibrant trace upon the canvas of our lives. As we reach the end of this journey into the nature of passion, let's pivot to something actionable, something that can spark light in those seeking to explore their own passions, whether they be singular or diverse. Firstly, embrace exploration. Allow yourself to venture into unknown territories, try new experiences, and meet new people. Sometimes, passion is waiting in the places we least expect. Next, pay attention to your curiosities and what naturally draws you in. Often, the things that quietly pique our interests can lead to deeper passions when given the space to grow. Reflect on your childhood interests. Sometimes, the unfiltered joys of our younger selves hold clues to passions that have been buried under adult responsibilities and expectations. Don't be afraid to let go of what's no longer fulfilling. Just because you were once passionate about something doesn't mean you have to remain tied to it forever. Give yourself permission to change. And finally, remember that passion doesn't have to be profound. It can be found in the small things that make us smile, that bring peace to our chaos, or that excite our souls even for a moment. In closing, whether you discover a singular, all-consuming passion or a bouquet of varied interests, the key is to stay curious. Allow your journey to be one of continual discovery, adapting with each experience and savoring the richness it brings to your life. Thank you for joining me on this exploration. Keep wondering. Keep discovering. And most importantly, stay curious.